25 times. How many times is by the name Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned by name? 4 times. Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse 43, Surah Azab chapter 33 verse 40, Surah Fatah chapter 48 verse 29, Surah Muhammad chapter 47 verse number 2, fingertips. And at Ahmad once, Surah Saf chapter 61 verse number 6, fingertips. You want to know what does the Quran speak about Nisa, woman? Press the button, you get the answer. You press another button, the printout comes out. You want to know what does the hadith say about Salah? Press the button, you get the answer. Which is the Sahih hadith, which is the Zaif hadith? Everything on your fingertips. The world is advancing. How many people utilize compact disc for research of Islam, for studying Islam? How many people? Can anyone raise their hand who uses compact disc? CD-ROM, you know? CD-ROM. One, Alhamdulillah. See, leave aside creating, we don't have people using it. If we don't use it, how will we have the market? See, everything. We have the Qiraat of the Quran on audio CD, on CD-ROM. We have the translations in several languages. You have fiqh, sharia, hadith, everything on it. You have Islamic games for children. How do you attract children? You have to make a child Islamic from day one. Don't wait till he grows an adult and then talk about Islam. Right from the beginning, we in IRF have a children's wing, mainly catering from the age of 3 to 9. Right from young, you train them. Train them to be journalists, good in writing, right from the beginning. Don't wait till they become graduate and then train them. That you can do to those people who don't have the opportunity. That also you have to do. But catch them young. We have games on the computer, how to influence children to come closer to Islam. They get entertained and yet they learn. And I've given a talk on Islam for children, you can observe that cassette. And I've shown the technique, how to attract the children right from childhood. Now world is advancing. Previously we had the telephone, then we had the fax. Now we have the email. Email, called the electronic mail. Very cheap. Normally when I send a fax to America, every page I have to spend about 100 to 150 rupees, depending upon the matter. In email, I send several pages only for 1 rupee. 1 rupee. But unfortunately, the Muslim organization don't have email. Now they have started. We are so backward. When the full world advances, then we Muslims want to adopt that. In email, you can communicate cheap, very fast, electronic mail. You type on your computer, press the button, reaches there. Simple. He opens his box. Box means he doesn't have to go to a post box. It just depresses the button, it comes on his screen. Easy. Directly from your doorstep to his doorstep. In fact, it takes time. Every page goes through here. Just press the button, reach it directly. How many people are utilizing this? Do you know today on the internet? Internet is advancing. The majority material on the internet on Islam is against Islam. Do you know that? On the internet, if you read about Islam, mainly there are non-Muslims written against Islam. They're mentioning Quran is not the word of God. There are so many grammatical errors in the Quran. There are so many unscientific points in the Quran, which no Muslim is replying. It's a shame on us. No Muslim is replying. Very few organizations. There are chatting channels on the internet. There are channels. How you have satellite channels? It's somewhat different, but even they are called chatting channels. On the internet, you have chatting channels. Many of them are run by Christian missionary, known as Jesus Cafe, etc. When you enter this channel, you can have a question answer session with them. We in IRF, Alhamdulillah, we sit in Bombay and do dawah on an individual basis with people in America, people in UK, people in Singapore, throughout the world, Alhamdulillah, at the fingertips. We type, the question comes on his screen. He gives the answer, it comes on our screen. Are you aware that you can do dawah sitting in your home, sitting in your office, on one-to-one basis? You know, if I have to speak on telephone for 2 hours, you know how much I have to spend? If I have to speak to America 2 hours, how much will it cost me? How much? Tens of thousands of rupees. On email, that's 10, 20 rupees. 30, 40 rupees. And not with one person, simultaneously I'm speaking with 20 people. It's like conferencing. I'm having a conference telephone with the person in America, one sitting in London, one sitting in Singapore, one in Malaysia, conferencing. All five are chatting with each other, doing dawah. If I have a conference line, how much will it cost me? The world is advancing. How many people know how to use the internet? But doing dawah, presenting Islam on these chatting channels is a different technique. It's altogether different. See, having knowledge of Islam is a must for any type of dawah. Whether oral, whether writing, whether video, knowledge. But the technique keeps on changing. And we at IRF, alhamdulillah, we train the people how to talk. And we have a unique style of doing da'wah, that whenever we meet a non-Muslim or non-Muslim comes to us, instead of talking 1,000 good points about Islam, even after we convince 1,000 good points about Islam, that non-Muslim will say, you're the man who marries more than one woman, you're the man who keeps the woman in the veil. Oh, you're the people who don't have alcohol, don't have pork. You're the people who have non-veg, ruthless people. You speak 1,000 good points, but the few negative points in his mind will never make him accept Islam. Never. So what we do, instead of talking 1,000 good points about Islam, what we say is, what do you think is wrong with Islam? With your limited knowledge, whether right or wrong, whatever knowledge you have about Islam from media, from newspaper, from television, from magazines, what do you feel is wrong with Islam? And we tell him, brother, you're most welcome to criticize Islam, no problem, we can take it. We can take it. You want to criticize the Quran, no problem. Just give us the reason, why do you criticize it? So they come up with their questions. And we have done a survey and we have come to know there are hardly 20 questions which the non-Muslims have against Islam, which a common non-Muslim has. The common non-Muslim is 80% non-Muslim. If they ask you questions on Islam, they will ask you 5 or 6 questions. All these 5 or 6 questions asked by common 80% of the non-Muslim will fall within these 20 questions. We have done a survey. Common 20 questions. Like, as I told you, why is a Muslim man allowed to have more than one wife? Why do you keep the woman in the veil? Why do women inherit half the share of the men? Why do you all have non-veg? Why don't you all have pork? Why don't you have alcohol? What's the meaning of jihad? Why do you all worship the Kaaba? Why aren't non-Muslims allowed in the holy city of Makkah? These are the common questions they ask. What we do, we want each and every Muslim in the world should be able to answer these questions pit-pat, with references. And these common 20 questions will remain the same, irrespective whether you are in India, whether in America, whether in Europe, throughout the world, these 20 common questions are the same. There may be additional 2 or 3 questions based on the locality. Like when I had gone to state, the additional question was that, can we buy a house, mortgage, loan from a bank? Allowed, haram or halal. Can we have chicken from McDonald's? Can we have Kentucky Fried Chicken? Additional 2 questions. But the remaining 20 questions are the same. See, these 20 questions have emerged. How? Because the media is bombarding, by the help of the media, they're bombarding the people with this information. Against women, women in Islam don't get their rights, Quran conflicts with science. So these 20 questions have emerged. These 20 questions may change after 5 years, after 2 years. But today, these 20 questions are prevalent. So if every Muslim knows the answer of these 20 questions, you can neutralize 80% of the non-Muslims, 80%. These 20 questions may change after a few years. But now, you should be prepared. And when you give the answer, we give the answer on various levels. We should train them, we should be professionals. How many professional da'is do we have? How many? How many full-time da'is do we have in the Muslim world? Supposed to be a religion of missionaries. Do you know the Christians have 60,000 crusaders raising dust throughout the world? 60,000 paid people, paid full-time workers. Not clerks and all, actual da'wah giving talks throughout the world. 60,000. How many international da'is do we have? You can count them on your fingertips. How many? It's a shame on us. We are supposed to be a religion of missionaries. It's a shame on us. And when we give the replies, we go on various levels. First quote from the scripture, if it's there in the Quran or the Hadith, give the quotation. If it's there in the religious scripture of the Hindu, the Bible, quote that. Then go to the level. Second level is of logic. Third is of science. Give the answers on different levels, quoting scriptures, our scripture and their scriptures. Then quote the answer with reason and then with scientific data and statistics. For example, someone asks us, why not to have pork? If you ask this question to any IRF speaker, Islamic Research Foundation speaker, the tape recorder will go on. It's mentioned in the Quran in no less than 4 different places. Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse number 173, Surah Maidah chapter 5 verse number 3, Surah An'am chapter 6 verse number 145, Surah Nahl chapter 16 verse number 115. Then quote Arabic. Hurrimat alaykumul maitutu waddamu walahmul khinzir wama uhilla li ghayril labi. Forbidden for you for food, dead meat, blood, the flesh of swine, and any food on which any name besides Allah has been invoked. Quote from the Bible. The Bible says in Leviticus chapter number 11 verse number 7 and 8, in the book of Deuteronomy chapter number 14 verse number 8, in the book of Isaiah chapter 65 verse number 2 to 5.